real quick. Number one, defensive man. Defensive man. You are imperative this week. It is your job to make the offensive guy the lucky million bucks. To make sure he does everything right. So you have to give me the correct defensive reaction. Just because you're not hitting the shot doesn't mean you're not important. You have to give me the appropriate reaction for the offensive guy to learn the technique. That's number one. Number two, Mario's in his stance. I said I have to beat his head and his hands before I can beat his hips. Steps one, two, and three, right? I saw some people do this, and this is not what I did. That's why I teach it this way. I saw a couple guys go out there and do this. Guys, you want to beat the stud? That ain't gonna work. I have to beat his head in the stance first. Mario's gonna stance. How do I beat his head in the stance? What? Setup. That's correct, but there's two things I have to do with my setup to beat his stance. How do I beat his head? That's how I beat his hands. How do I beat his head? I pull set down, but what am I doing? What am I doing? Not what? What? I'm not snapping them down. I'm pulling down. Say it.
Change bubbles.
Refill. Man, good job. Hey, he's completely right. I beat his hands by being inside. Look. I'm inside his hands. He has outside ties or elbow binds. I beat his head by being lower. I change level. He raises up. My head's lower than his head. Then I can get to his legs. You have to understand this. The better my setup, the better my shot, the easier my finish. If you understand that, then you'll understand my next statement. Guys, forget every finish you know. Screw every finish. If I don't ever beat his head in his hands, I'm never going to get to his leg, so you don't need to know a finish. You need to know how to set a guy up. The setup is the most important thing. If I don't ever beat his head in his hands, I'm never going to get to his legs. I can never score this. If I can't get to his legs, I can't get 2 points. Does that make sense? The setup is the key. The better my setup, the better my shot. The easier my finish. You guys with me? So concentrate on the setup when you go back out there. Don't get me wrong. You still have to be in your stance. You still have to move. You still have to do all these other things right. But if I don't do the very first thing right, beat his head in his hands, it doesn't matter how good my stance is, I can't get to his legs, so I can't finish and get 2 points. So here we go. We're just going to do a simple double leg lift. Now when we do this double leg lift, watch your area. Don't run into anybody, all right? Here we go. Inside thigh collar tie. I'll pull my elbows right back here in my stance. I circle to my left towards my inside thigh. I plant my left foot. My right leg steps forward. I shoot both arms. Here, my straight leg steps up high. I drive up. I go into Mario, then I circle back. Right off my circle back motion, I'm going to take a step with my right leg in front of Mario's body. Here, I just shifted all the weight to Mario's left leg. Right now, I'm holding Mario up so he doesn't fall down. Here, he's got perfect balance. I just shifted all the weight right here to this left leg. I step. From here, I want to pop my hips, drive, and re-penetrate. Pop, drive, re-penetrate. I take another knee over toe penetration. I say double leg lift. You guys think John Cena, WWE, which is number one completely wrong, it's the WWF, all right? It's not WWE, it's always gonna be the WWF, with Hogan, Ric Flair, Macho Man Randy Savage, all right? You guys think, lift this dude up, carry him around on your shoulder, do the flex, all right? It's not all that. I'm clearing Mario's legs about this far. I'm getting his feet off the mat about this far. And I just clear his legs, and I take another knee over toe penetration. Here's why I take another knee over toe. About 5 years ago, we had a guy at the state tournament. He lifts the guy here. He carries him around on his shoulder. He goes and take him back to the mat. Here, the guy lays on the mat, does one of those. We lose a state title. We got called for an illegal slam. If I hit another knee over penetration. I can't sing. This comes off my circle back motions. All week long, with the exception of a few techniques, we're going to be shifting all the weight to Mario's left side of his body, to his left leg, his left hip, his left knee, his left hand. Everything's going to be shifted there. Right? You have to shift the weight there. How do I shift the weight there? Watch. Here, I go into him. I circle back. Now look, all the weight is currently on Mario's left foot. I'm just going to keep it there. I step. I pop. I drive. Repenetrate. Step. Pop. Drive. Repenetrate. All the way through. Does that make sense? Timmy. Mario, inside tight collar stop. Double leg lift. Hit. Circle back, step, pop, drive, repenetrate, Timmy. Inside side collar top. Double leg lift, hit him. Now, what did Timmy do wrong there?
He hit a high crouch and then switch.
Which is okay, that's a valid technique, but the biggest thing he did wrong was what? What? No, he repenetrated. What did he do? He did not circle back. You have to circle back. Why? Because it's the weight of the left foot. Look how big and strong Timmy is. He's built like a brick house, man. He just powers through people. Why? He's got that God-given ability. He's had it since he's been this big. Timmy hits a double leg and he stands right up to his feet. He's just that strong. Me? Never going to happen. For 90% of guys, you have to circle back. Does anybody need to see it again? Hey, do me a favor. If I'm right here, and I'm getting ready to finish, and step across, and I'm going to run into these guys, what should I do? Circle back, find the open space here. I circle back, there's the space, step, pop, drive, free penetration. Let's get a shot. One, two, three. Let's go!